In this video, we're going to practice finding the area bounded by two curves. So here are the directions. Find the area of the region bounded by y equals x squared plus 2x minus 6 and y equals 3x. So in some problems like this, where you're trying to find the area between two curves, you are already given a specific interval over which to find that area. But in some cases, you're not, and that's a case you're going to look at here. We're not given a specific A and B, and actually what's going to determine that are the intersection points of these curves. Right? That's going to kind of mark out the region bounded by these curves. So what we probably want to start by doing is getting just a sketch or a general idea of what this region is going to look like. We want to include which function is on top and then also the intersection points that bound the region. Now, in reality, a lot of you are probably going to use your calculator to help you do this. But just for the sake of understanding the process, let's just try to get a quick sketch by hand first. And then we'll verify it on the calculator, and then we'll actually calculate the area of the region. So in my sketch, I don't care a lot about specific details. What I'm mainly concerned about is which function is on top and where they intersect. So this is just going to be a rough sketch. Let's start by sketching y equals 3x. That's a little bit easier to deal with. That's just, of course, a slanted line that goes through the origin with a slope of 3. And then my other function here is a parabola. Now the parabola is a little harder to draw, but we can get a little bit of information just from a first glance. I know that my y-intercept is negative 6. So that's pretty helpful. So let's just say this is negative 6. And I know it opens up. So that kind of tells me a lot already. Now I don't really know by first glance what the x-intercepts are, but that doesn't really matter so much. So we're just going to not worry about those and just kind of sketch in just a generic parabola shape with the understanding that these x-intercepts could be shifted. Okay, so now we can kind of see what this region looks like. We can see that this line, y equals 3x, is definitely on top. The parabola is on the bottom. But the last details we need to figure out are these intersection points. So let's go ahead and figure those out algebraically, and then we'll put them into our drawing. Now, the way we figure out intersection points algebraically is by setting the two functions equal to each other and solving for x. So here I'm going to move everything to the left side of the equal sign and write this as x squared minus x minus 6 equals 0. And then I'm going to try to factor this. And actually this factors pretty nicely. This is x minus 3 times x plus 2 equals 0. And then we can see our two solutions are x equals 3 and x equals negative 2. And those correspond to the intersection points in my picture. So this rightmost intersection point here should be 3. And this one to the left over here should be negative 2. So now I have all the information I need to actually calculate the area between the curves. Let me really quickly show you the actual graph of this, just to verify that we have the right region. So based on this, it looks like we did pretty good. And it looks like we got our intersection points correct as well. Okay, so let's actually calculate the area between these curves now. So in general, the area is going to be given by a definite integral of the top function minus the bottom function, integrated over whatever interval you're concerned with. So then let's plug in our relevant information. We know our interval should be from negative 2 to 3. Our top function is 3x. Our bottom function is x squared plus 2x minus 6. You want to make sure to put that in parentheses so you remember to distribute the minus sign to all terms. And we're integrating with respect to x. Okay, so if we just expand inside that integral, we get 3x minus x squared minus 2x plus 6 dx, which I can simplify just a little bit to, let's see, I'll write this as negative x squared plus x plus 6 dx. Now we can go ahead and find the antiderivative. If we do that, we get negative x cubed over 3 plus x squared over 2 plus 6x, and we want to evaluate from negative 2 to 3. So if we go ahead and plug in 3 first, we should get the following. And then we plug in negative 2 as well. And we're subtracting those. And then we'll just go through several steps to simplify this. And of course, you could do these in your calculator. And we should get the following. So it looks like after working out all those values in fractions, we end up with 125 over 6 as our final answer for the area bounded by these curves.